Hello everyone, welcome to MifraTech. Today in this section we learn about Pandas library, which is a library available in Python, which is largely used in machine learning and artificial intelligence in Python also. It is mainly used in order to handle the data frames. So here Pandas provides us the data frame which will help us to visualize the data very easily and work with the data sets also. So now in this section I'm going to show you some example programs and how we can access what are the different functions available in Pandas library. So here I am going to work with the Jupyter notebook available in Anaconda Navigator. So you can same core program you can execute in the any IDE like PyCharm or any normal Python IDE, or you can do it in a Spider or a Jupyter notebook also. So now I will go to my home page of system and open the Anaconda Navigator now. So when you go to the home page of here, in order to open the Jupyter notebook, first you open Anaconda Navigator. So it should be previously installed in your system. So when I type here Anaconda Navigator, as you can see Anaconda Navigator, Anaconda 3, it will show. Just open that one. So when you open that one, so next it will show. Here home is the home page of Anaconda Navigator. Here I want to install launch my Jupyter notebook. As you can see here, it is Jupyter notebook here. There is a launch option available. Just click on this launch one. So when you click on this launch one, this Jupyter notebook will be opened in your whatever the default browser available in your system. At the default browser it will open. So as you can see here, it has opened in my default browser. So now I will open my Pandas work.python, that is Jupyter notebook. So now we'll open that one. See here, now I have opened my Pandas Jupyter notebook. Now I am going to explain you what and all the different things available in this Pandas library. We'll run some program here. So here Pandas, what is Pandas means, as I told, it is a Python library mainly used for working with the data sets. So it is mainly work with the data set, so it is widely used in whenever you are using data set in your program like machine learning, artificial intelligence, data science, so on all those things we'll use this, widely use this Pandas library. So it has the functions of analyzing, cleaning, exploring and manipulating the data. Here the name Pandas has referenced for both panel data and Python data analysis. That is why it is a Pandas, and was mainly created by that Wes McKinney in 2008. So this is the history about this Pandas library. What is Pandas? So as I told earlier itself, so what this Pandas can do means, Pandas can give you answer about data like, is there a correlation between two or more columns in a particular data? What is the average value of values of a particular column? What is the maximum value? What is the minimum values? Is there any empty cells or null values present in the data set? Those things you can also find using this, there are inbuilt function available in this Pandas library. So you can make use of that in order to find those things required for your project. And you can also, in order to clean the data, you can use this Pandas library. So now I will show you how you can use this Pandas in different ways. First I will show you how we can import this Pandas library. So before importing, the Pandas should be installed in your system first. If you are not installed, means go to command prompt to your system and just write pip install Pandas. So the Pandas will be installed. After that, in order to use the installed Pandas in your system, you should use the keyword here, import Pandas. So this is the library that is available here. So when you install the import Pandas, the Pandas will be imported. So now you can use this Pandas library. So now I am going to show you how you can do different operations along with the data set when you're using Pandas library. So here I am creating a data set. So my data set, a variable I have created equal to here I am creating a data set with a dictionary data set here, which has a key value is cars. Within that, and I am giving BMW, Volvo, Ford as the values. Similarly, one more key I am creating here, dictionary passings. Here for that I am giving values, a least value 372. So this is the dictionary I have created. So now I will convert my dictionary into a data frame using Pandas. So Pandas dot data frame, inside the Pandas there is a inbuilt function available, that is data frame, which will convert whatever the data set will provide into a data frame. So Pandas dot data frame of my dictionary, my data set I am passing as a parameter. So whatever the resulted data frame I am getting, I am storing in a new variable myVar. So now I will print my resulted new data set, print of my var. If I run this program, you can see how my data will look like, data frame will look like. See, now you can see the output when I run this program. See, now you can see when I run this program, my whatever the data set, dictionary data set have, that it converted into data frame. This is how data frame will look like. As you can see, cars, all the cars will be available in one column, and we have indexes also like 0, 1, 2 in order to get the counting values and passing BMW 3, Volvo 7, Ford 2. So in the same line it is showing. So in this way, it mainly this converting any data set into, like in the data frame, if you convert pandas data frame, it will help us to analyze the data very easily. It will, in the data frame you can analyze. So see, at the 0th index, like our first position we have BMW, it has a passing 3. Like that you can analyze the data very easily whenever convert into a data set into a data frame. So the inbuilt function available in pandas is pandas.dataframe of whatever the data you have to convert into data frame, that data you have to pass as a parameter. Here I am passing a dictionary as a parameter here. So usually we'll whenever we import pandas, we'll use the pandas as the alias, that is PD we use the alias. So import pandas as PD. So whatever the imported pandas, that I'm assigning to one new variable, that is PD, that is nothing but using alias name. So generally we'll use this one only. So import pandas as PD. So later section of the program we'll use like this only. So import pandas as PD. So whatever the program I have shown you earlier itself, the same program I'm writing, showing now here using pandas as a alias name I will use now. So import pandas as PD. So I am creating the same dictionary data set, so which has cars and passing. So now I am calling PD dot data frame of. So instead of pandas, you can directly call now PD dot data frame of. So my data set, the dictionary I am passing as a parameter. So whatever the data frame I am getting, that I am storing in a variable my var. So now I will print my output. So if I run this program, I will get the same output like how I got in the previous program. See, as you can see here, cars, I got a data frame which has cars in one column, passings in one column. So next I will show you how we can check the current version, or what is the version of pandas you are using. In order to check that, there is an inbuilt function available in pandas, that is you can see here, first we will import the pandas. So import pandas as PD. So the inbuilt function available in pandas is the underscore version underscore. So PD dot underscore version underscore, if you print this, it will give the what is the version of the pandas you are using. If I run this program, you can see clearly in the output, the version of pandas I am using is 0.25.1. So this is the version of pandas. So by using this underscore version underscore function, you can check what is the current version, or what is the version of the pandas you are working. So next, pandas also has a pandas has both data frame and series. Now as pandas has series, what is pandas series we'll discuss now. So generally, what is a pandas series means? A pandas series like a column in a table. So a series is like, if you consider a table, means each column in a table we'll call it as a series. It is a one dimensional array holding a data of any type. So like a single column we'll call as a pandas series. This is like a one dimensional array which will hold any type of data it will hold. Now we'll see how we can create a pandas series and what is the keyword we should use. So first import pandas as PD. After that, here I am creating a list now. So A is equal to 172. This is the list I am creating here. So here now I will create a pandas series from this list. So PD dot series, series of, this is the function we should use in order to create a pandas series. So PD dot series of, I am passing a list as a parameter. So whatever the result I am getting, it is a pandas series that I am storing in a variable my var. So now I will print my series. So if I run this program, you can see how my list data has converted into series. So as you can see here, my output is printing my 172 list. Whatever the number present in my list has converted into pandas series. As I told, pandas series is like a column of data. So as you can see, all the elements present in the list has converted into pandas series. So it is displaying in a column. So 172 along with the indexes it will show. At the 0th position it has 1, at the 1 index it has 7, like that it will show. In this way, pandas series you can create from a list also. So next, we can also like give labels to the whatever the values we created. Like You can see when we defaultly create any series or data frame, defaultly it is giving some 0, 1, 2 as a normal indexes. We can also change the name of these indexes. We can provide names for those indexes. Now I will show you how we can do that. So now I will show you how we can access elements present in the pandas series. So in order to access, I am using here print my where of 0. So you should just call the name of the pandas series and you should pass the index, particular index of that value which you wanted to access. So print of my var of 0 or 0th index, whatever the value or the number present in the pandas series, that I am accessing. If I run this program, you can see in the output now. See, you can see in the output now at the 0th index, element present in this pandas series is 1. As you can see here, 0th index we have 1. So in this way you can provide like access the element present in a pandas here. Now I will show you how we can create labels like whatever the index 0, 1, 2 we are getting, we can change the name of that index according to our wish, like how we, what and all the labels we want, we can give that. Now I will show you how we can do that. So first we will import pandas as pd. Now we will create a list here, 172 is a list which has element 172 that I am storing in a variable a. So now I will create a pandas series. So pd.series of, so now I am passing list as a parameter in order to create the pandas series. After that I am taking one more argument, index. So here there is a one more parameter available in pandas series, that is index. So index equal to, so now I am giving index name labels, that is index I am giving as x, we should give given in the single or double quote, x, y, z, these are the names of the indexes I am giving. That should be given as it has a 3 elements, I should provide that much of labels. So x, y, z I am storing like passing as a list here. If I close this one and my panda series get created with this new indexes, if I print my new data panda series, you can get to know how it has changed my indexes value into according to labels has got changed. As you can see here, previously when I directly without passing the indexes, if I changed like my pandas series was giving 0, 1, 2 as a default indexes. Now I have labeled my indexes as according to x, how I want. I named it as x, y, z. So as you can see, x, y, z has came in the indexes. So x has in the x position, it has 1, y, 2, y, 7, z, 2, like that. You can also change the labels of the indexes. You can now, you can, if you want to access the element present in that particular pandas series, means instead of 0, 1, 2, you should mention the whatever the label you have given. So print, if you want to access the element present at the second index, that is y, means you should give only y here. So my var of y, if I give print my of y, you can see here when I run this program, my output is 7. If you want to access the 7, means you should give that print my var of whatever the label you have given, store that variable, particular element, that variable you should give as a parameter here. Next, I will show you how we can convert convert a dictionary into a pandas series. So when we convert our dictionary into pandas series, how will our output will look like, that I will show you now. So first we'll import the pandas library. So import a pandas as pd. So after importing the pandas library, we'll create a dictionary. So the name of the dictionary I have taken is calories. Here I'm taking key as day 1, day 2, day 3 as a key values, and values I'm storing in the day 1 value stored is 420. In day 2 380, day 3 390. This is the dictionary I have created. Now I will create my pandas series using this dictionary. So pd.series of, I am passing a dictionary as a parameter. Whatever the output I am getting, now I am getting a pandas series now. That I am storing in a variable myvar. Now I will print my output, my print of myvar. If I run this program, you can see here now how my output will look like. So as you can see, whenever I convert a dictionary into pandas series, my output will look like this. So whatever the key values I have, that will be assigned to as a syntax, like that key values will be assigned as a indexes, key values, key, only keys will be assigned as indexes, values of that particular key will be stored in will come in a single column in front of that particular index, that is key. So at day 1 420, day 2 380, day 3 390. So if you convert a dictionary, like dictionary into pandas series, you can analyze the data very easily at particular key what value we have, key value pair, you can see here day 1 420, day 2 380, day 3 390. In this way you can, it will help us to analyze the data very easily. So that is what the very important thing you should remember. Whenever you convert a dictionary into a pandas series, means whatever the keys we have, that will be converted, that will become the labels of the indexes of that particular pandas series. That is what the important thing. So So now I will show you how we can, like, as a, if we have a particular dictionary, how we can create a pandas series by only considering only a particular element from that particular dictionary. We are not considering the whole dictionary. A part of the dictionary also we can create, from the part of the dictionary also we can create a new series. That I will show you how we can do that. So here in this particular example, I am creating a series using only a data of only key day 1 and day 2 keys I am using here. Day 3 I am not using. Now I will show you how we can do that. So import pandas as pd. So after importing pandas library, so here calor is a dictionary I am creating. So day 1 420, similarly day 2 380, day 3 390, same dictionary I have created, stored in the variable calor. So now I will create my pandas series. So pd.series of dictionary I am passing as a parameter. Now I will mention my indexes. So index equal to one more argument, as I told, it will take index equal to inside the square brackets I am passing here day 1 and day 2. So here, as I told earlier itself, whenever you convert a dictionary into pandas series, the keys will become the indexes. As I am passing indexes, normally whatever the key values you want, up like what and all, the only part of the keys you want to convert into series, only those and the indexes you show, you mention that those keys only, that will be converted into pandas series. Here I am passing indexes as day 1 and day 2. I am not passing day 3, so that whatever the result I am getting, showing in my where variable. If I print this variable, I will run this program and I will show you what kind of output will get now. So when I run this program, you can see only day 1 420, day 2 380. I am not getting day 3 because I have restricted my index like that. I have externally given the index. I am not mentioned day 3 here. If you mention day 3 also, like, you will get the day 3. Otherwise, if I mention remove here day 2 also, I will remove and show you what kind of output will get. When I remove this one day 2 also, if I run this, I will get only day 1 as a new pandas series. So as you can see, only day 1 it is showing 420. Day 2 and day 3 I am not mentioning. If you want to mention them also, means you should give, if you want to print all the elements, means you need not to mention the indexes externally. Otherwise, if you want to only want a part of the dictionary, means you should mention the particular keys, day 1, day 2 or day 3, whatever you want. So next we'll discuss about pandas data frame. So there is one more thing we can create in the pandas is data frame. That I showed, one example I shown in the earlier itself, how pandas data frame will look like. Now I will show you some more example how we can create a data frame. So here, when you want to create a data, so the particular example what I am showing here, I am going to create a data frame from two series. Now I am going to consider two series. From those two series I will create a data frame. So import pandas as pd. Here a dictionary I am creating here, series. So data of calories, it has 2 420 380, these are the values. Duration have, so whatever the inside the flower bracket I am taking, it is not a dictionary here, it is a, you can see here, it is not a key value pair. You can see here two separate series I have created. So now I will pass this as a parameter in order to create the data frame. So frame, so pd dot data frame of, this is the keyword you should use in order to create a data frame in pandas. So pd dot data frame of, I am passing that two series, that is data as the parameter. Whatever the data frame I am getting, showing in the variable myvar. If I run this program, you can see in the output how my data got converted. As you can see here, it is showing the indexes and calories have 320 420 380 390. It will be showed in one column. Similarly, duration I am getting 50 40 45. You can easily analyze the data when you convert any data into data frame, pandas data frame. So if you have a doubt what is the data frame, is pandas data frame is nothing but a two dimensional structure. It is like a two dimensional array with a table which contains both rows and columns. It will help us to analyze the data very easily. So next we'll see how we can locate a particular row of the data frame. If you want to access a particular row from a table, like as I told, pandas data frame is like a table, it has both rows and columns. If you want to access a particular row from the data frame, means how we can do that, means now I will show you in the particular example. Here in this example I will show you how we can whatever the data frame I have created previously, from that how we can access the first row. If you want to access the first row, what is the thing we should give, means here I am accessing first row. So print data frame df dot location, you should use, this is the keyword you should use, df dot, that is a data frame of loc. So this is the keyword you should hear here. So df dot location of, here inside that square bracket you should mention the syntax. If you want first row, means 0 you should mention. If you want second row means you should pass 2 like 1, next to third row means 2, so it will pass start from 0th index. So if you mention means that particular row's value you will get. So if I run this program, we will get to know the output now. So as you can see here, now it is showing name df is not defined because here I didn't run this program. So whatever the previous program I have created data frame, here instead of data frame I have stored my data frame in the variable df. Will run this program, it is same as the previous program which I have run. So now I will run this. Now you can get to know the output now. So as you can see my output at the 0th location, when I access the 0th row, at the 0th row I have column 420 calories, the value present at the calories column is 420, duration have 50. So in this way you can easily get to know a particular row, what is the value present with the index name also it will show calories 420, duration 50. As you can see here, 0th row index it is calories 420, duration 50. So in this way you can easily access the value present at a particular row also. So if you want to access value present at a particular, if you want to access more than 2 rows, if you want to access 0th row, 1 row and 2 row, that also you can mention. So using print of df dot location of, here I am passing 2 rows, I want a values present in the 0th row and 1th row also, so I am passing 0 comma 1. If I run this program, we will get to know what kind of output I will get now. We'll run it now. So as you can see here, when I run this program, as you can see in the output, it has at the 0th location I have calories 420, duration 50. At the one location, row and throw, first row I have calories 380, duration 50. So in this way you can access more than one row element also present in the data frame. So now next I will show you how we named indexes at the series, pandas series while creating. We can also name our indexes according to what are all the labels we want in pandas data frame also. Now I will show you with the same example. So import pandas as pd, here I have created a series here. So here whatever the series I have created, so I am converting into data frame. So pd.data frame of, I am passing this data as a parameter here. Here I am mentioning index is equal to, so default it will give index 0, 1, 2. Now I am changing that to according to my wish. So I am giving the indexes as day 1, day 2 and day 3. If I storing this data frame into df, if I print this my data frame, you can see in the output how it will look like. When I run this program, as you can see, my index has from 0, 1, 2, it has changed it to day 1, day 2, day 3, which I have mentioned in the index. For the day 1, you can analyze this. Day 1, calories is 420, duration 50. Day 2, calories 380, duration 440. So in this way, it mainly helps us to analyze the data very easily. So now I wish, how we access the particular row using indexes. If you want to access now the particular row means as I change my indexes into labels, however according to my wish. If you want to access the particular row means you should give, instead of 0, 1, 2 index, you should give that particular label. Now I will show you how can. If you want to access the data of the day 2 means, now day 2 means row 2, you should give is print of df dot look of day 2, you should mention as a parameter here. If I run this program, you can see here at day 2 calories is 380, duration 40. You can see in the output, see here day 2 we have calories 380, duration 40. In this way you should mention the label as a parameter inside this location, not to access the element present in particular row. So now I will show you how we can load files into a data frame. If you have a already have some data set available in Excel sheet, in Excel format or .csv, that is comma separated value, there are different type of data sets available. How we can open those data set in pandas and how we can do some operation with those pandas data set, with those available data set, I will show you. So this is very important usually in machine learning or artificial data science. Usually we'll import some data set available in different website and we'll do some operations. So in order to do that, loading the data set is very important. How we can do that? Because those data set usually will be in a Excel format, Excel sheet format, or will be in CSV file. Now I will show you how. Generally now all the data set will be available in CSV file. CSV is nothing but comma separated value file. It is like an Excel file. So now I will show you how we can load the data into a data frame. So because pandas will provide us more function in order to like load those data and do some operation with those data sets. So now I will show you how we can load a CSV file into data frame. CSV is nothing but comma separated file, comma separated value file. So first we will import pandas as a PD. So here I am reading a data set which is available in my system. I have downloaded some example data set. So now I will show you that is in .csv format. Now I will show you how we can open a data set using pandas library. So and how we can convert them into new data frame. First we will convert into data frame. So import pandas as pd. So here I am calling pd.read_csv. So this is the inbuilt function available in data pandas library in order to read a data set which is available in which is there in CSV format. So pd.read_csv of, so inside this you should mention the particular name of the data set. So here the name of the data set which I have taken is data.csv, that you should mention here. So whatever the data frame I am getting, that I am storing in a variable df. If I print that df, I am going to get my data set now as a data like in the form of a data frame. If I run this program, you can see my output. See, as you can see here, whatever the data set I have taken, it has a, these are the different columns present in that particular data frame. So it is also showing the indexes. It has up to 0 to 1900 rows of data available in my particular data set which I have considered. It has a name of the column is region, country, item, type, like that, sales channel, order priority, order date, order ID, ship date. So these are the different columns present in my particular data set. As you can see here, still there are different columns. So at, when you come to at last of the output, you can see here how many number of rows and columns present in my particular data frame will be displayed in the at the end of my data frame when I print my data frame. As you can see, it has 100 rows and 14 columns. So whatever the data set I have considered here, it has 100 rows and 14 columns. So when I display my data frame, my all the like some example starting 5 rows and last 5 rows of data will be displayed here, all the from the all the columns, as you can see here. So in this way you can read a CSV data format, CSV data set using pd.read_csv, and you can store it as a data frame and you can print the data frame. And at last you can also see when you print the data frame, it will show number of rows and columns present in the particular data set. Now I will show you what in all the different operation we can do when we load a data set and what we can do in that particular data set. So as I told you earlier itself, how we can import that, load the CSV data frame, CSV data frame into data frame. We can also convert that whatever the data frame whatever the data set we have converted into data frame, that data frame also we can convert it into string format. If you want to convert that data frame into string format, means there is a function available in pandas, that is first we'll import pandas as pd. So pd.read_csv of data, it has converted my data set ready, it has loaded into data frame. So whatever the data frame I have, I'm converting into string now. So df.to_string of, so this to_string of function will convert my data frame into string. If I print that, if I run this program, you can see in the output now how my output will look like. As you can see here, initially when I converted my CS, loaded my data set which has converted into data frame, it is looking like this, as you can see in the output. So when I converted my data frame into string format, see, as you can see, using to_string format, as you can see my data will look like this. So it is not a good thing of converting my data frame into string format, because it is not help us to analyze the data. You can just visualize the data, that's it, which is very like when the data are there in the data, like data frame format, means analyzing the data is very helpful. So only we will use pandas library as a pandas library data frame. So as I told earlier itself, whenever you read a data for like data data set available data set using pandas library, so the data frame whatever converted, if I print that data frame, only the first 5 columns and last 5 columns of that particular data set of that particular column it get displayed. As you can see, 0 to 4 means first 5 rows, 95 to 19 means this whatever the data set have, it has up to 100 rows and 14 columns. So from all the 14 columns, only first 5 data and last 5 data it is displaying. As you can see here itself, the data, this is by default it will display like that. So now we'll see what are all the different options, like functions available in order to analyze the data in pandas, and how we can analyze the data frames in pandas. So first thing, I will show you how we can view the data. So in order to view the data, there are different functions available in pandas. The first function is head of. So the head of method, whatever the head of method is, it helps us to view the data. So when we use this head of method, it mainly returns the headers. So headers means we inside the whenever use that head of method, by default if you not pass any argument within the head of method, it will just give the first 5 rows of like first row 5 rows of data of that all the columns. Otherwise you can also mention how many number rows of data you want inside the parameter, inside of the parameter to this head of function. Now I will show you how it will work. So here in this particular example, I am trying to print only the first 10 rows of data of that particular data set. So import pandas as pd. In order to read the CSV format data set, pd.read_csv, I am passing the name of the data set as the parameter. The name of the data set I am using is data.csv here, as you can see here. So now as I call data.csv, it has been read and stored in the variable df. So df is a data frame. Now I am trying to print only the first 10 rows of the data frame of each column. So df.head, so this function you should use, df.head of, inside the here, inside this head, if you pass 10 as a parameter, means up to 10, starting from 0 through up to 9, means 10 rows of data of each column will be displayed in the output. If I run this program, you can get to know the output. So as you can see here, if I run this program, see, as you can see, 0 to 9, first 10 rows of data of each column has displayed in the output. So in this way you can easily view the data by just mentioning how many number of rows of data you want inside this head of function. If we don't pass any parameter inside that head, we'll get only starting 5 rows of data, top 5 rows, that I will show you now. So this particular program, import pandas as pd. So I am reading the data set. So pd dot read underscore csv of the name of the data set, I'm storing in the variable df. So now I'm writing df dot head of. So just I'm calling the head of function, I'm not passing any argument. When I run this program, you can see in the output now. So 0 to 4 means the just top 5 rows of data will be displayed in each column. When I directly use df dot head of, that is head of function, you're not passing any parameter. If you pass a number of parameter, means that is nothing but number of rows you want to display, that you are giving as the argument. If you pass 100, means starting 100 rows of data will be displayed. Like that, this head of function will work in order to view the data present in the particular data frame. So there is one more method available, that is tail of method. What this tail of method will return, means it will, if you default without passing any parameter, if you use this tail of method, means it will return the last 5 rows of that particular data set of the like data present in particular column, last 5 data set will give. If I pass 10 means as a parameter to this tail of means, last like it will start from last 10 rows of data which will display from that particular data set. So now I will use this print tail method. So print of df dot tail of, so whatever the data frame previously I have created, for that only I am using this tail now. So when I call df dot tail of, default without passing any parameter, if I run this program, you will get to know. So as you can see here, I am getting all the rows, like only 5 rows of data. The now index, that is name of the index of the data, you can see here 95 to 99. As whatever the data set I have used, it has 100 columns, so 0 to 99. So it is, when I use tf dot tail of, means last 5 rows of data will be displayed. So starting from 99 to 95, 5 rows of data it has displayed from each column, as you can see in the output. If I pass any parameter to this tail, means at that quantity of rows will be displayed from the bottom of the data set. If I mention like 9, if I mention 9 means last, starting from the last 9 rows of data it will display. If I run this program, we will get to know. So as you can see here, now when I run this program, see, as you can see here, starting from 91 to 99. So all 9 rows of data starting from the bottom of the that one, it will give me as the output when I mention inside the parameter how many number of rows I want from the bottom of the data set. So in this way, this tail method will work. So these are the two different methods which help us to view the data, that is head of method and tail of method. Head of, in order to get the top data should be displayed from the top of the data set. If you use tail, means it will start from the display the data from the bottom of the data set, bottom row. So if you want any information about the database, you can get using a inbuilt method available in pandas, that is data frame, that is info of. So if you use this info of method, it will give the all the information about the particular data set. I will use that in a particular whatever the data frame which initially I have created, for that same data frame I am using that. So df.info, so when I call this df.info of function, if I run this program, you will get to know what and all information will get. So as you can see, when I run this program using df.info, the information I got is class. What is the class of the data frame? So pandas.core frame.data frame, whatever the df is there, it is a data frame object. It is showing this range index, so it has 100 entries, 0 to 99, like it has totally 100 rows starting from 0 to 99. That information also it will give. Next, data columns, how many number of columns of data the data frame has? 14, as I shown in earlier itself, it has 100 rows of data and 14 columns. So it is showing here in the range index, it will show 100 entries, 100 rows, the data columns, total 14 columns. So region, so there are different columns present in the particular data set. So the name of one column is region. So in this region, how many number of null object present, that will show. Null object means empty. Like there will be like whenever you take any data set, in some data set there will be like null object present. Means null object means it has doesn't have any value, just an empty cell will be present in the data set, that it is showing. So in region 1, in that column, name of the column is region, inside that it has 100 null object. In similar way, what and all the new different null object present in that particular column, it is showing. So here you see is the all the 14 columns, which are all the different null object it is present, it is showing. So here there is a in unit price, it has, as it is a integer value, it is showing 100 null non-null. So here in this region, 100 non-null object is present, means there is no null object present, it is showing. So all the details you can get from this, just using the df.info of this function will give all the details, all the information about the particular data set. So at last, you it will also show how many of float value, object values, or int value it has, and memory usage. What is the size of the memory used by this particular data frame? That also it will show. Like as you can see, 11.1 plus KB. That is the type data set memory it has used. So all the information about the data set you can get using this df.info function. So next we'll see how we can clean the data using pandas library. So cleaning the data itself is nothing but removing the unwanted columns or removing the cells which doesn't have any empty cells. This is nothing but the data cleaning, or removing the duplicate values or wrong data, wrong formatted values. That is what the cleaning of data means. So now I will show you how we can do this in pandas. First I will show you how we can clean the empty cells present in a data set using pandas. First I will show you how we can remove. In this particular program, I'm going to return a new data frame with no empty cells. If any empty cells present in my data set, means I'm going to remove that empty cells in my data frame. So import pandas as a pd. So here I'm reading a new data set here, so pd.read_csv. so whatever the data set I'm using here, now I'm not taking the whatever the previously taken data set. Whatever the data set I'm taking now, the name of the data set is new data and .csv. You can take any data set, you can download. So pd.read_sat, name of the data, that data frame converted, I'm storing in a variable df. So if you want to remove all the empty cells present in a particular data set, means you should use this function, that is df.dropna. So dropna, this is what the function name of the function, dropna. So if you use this dropna, means it will just remove all the empty cells present in that particular data set. Whatever the new data frame I'm getting after removing the empty cells, that I'm storing in a new variable, that is new_df. If I print my output, so new_df dot, so whatever the output I'm getting, that I'm converting into two string here. If you directly also, you can print my data. So now I will directly print and show you how it will work. If I run this program, you can see in the output now how it will remove the empty cells. So as you can see here, whatever the data set my data frame I have printed after removing the empty cells, you can see my whole data, my data frame here. In my data frame, it doesn't have any empty cells. As you can see, all the cells have filled the data. See here, you can see here like before doing the drop in, like removing the empty cells, I will print my original data set, whether it has any empty like empty data set or not, the, like empty cells or not, that we'll see now. Now I am printing both my original data and original data frame, as well as my new data frame which has removed the empty cells. See here, as you can see, this is my original data set which I have printed earlier. Here, as you can see, here the main columns, it has this duration, date, pulse, and max pulse calculation. These are the 5 columns present here. Here in the data, as you can see, and here NAN, whatever the NAN you are seeing, this is nothing but an empty cells. It doesn't have any values here. Removing these cells only, I am calling is removing the empty cells, because it will reduce the final efficiency when you are using it in this data set, when you use directly in machine learning algorithms or anything. So in order to increase the efficiency of that particular model while using in a particular project, we should remove this empty cell. So in order to that, as you can see, this whatever NAN you are seeing, it is the empty cell. You should use that particular method. What I have used is df dot drop na. So this is what the method in order to remove the empty cells from a particular data frame. So this is the original data set. So finally, as you can see here, below here, this is the new data set which have removed the empty cells from my original data set. So here, as you can see, in this data set, there is no NAN, empty cells is not present. Here, as you can see, I have displayed both. There is no empty set here, empty cells present in my new data frame. So in this way, you can remove the empty cells from that particular data set. So as I told, whatever the this drop the whenever use that method, it just remove the empty cells. That is, it will not change my original data set. If you want to change your original data frame, means you should use the in the whenever you do call the drop now method, inside that it will take one parameter, that is in place of that you should give true argument. If you pass as true argument, means my original data itself, it will change. So now I will show you how we can change our original data. So here in this example, whatever the original data set have, from that original data itself, I am removing all the empty cells, that is null values, and after that I'm removing it from the original data set only. I'm not assigning to new data frame. Now I will run this. See here, you can see import pandas as pd. I'm reading the CSV from a data set and converting it to data frame. So pd dot read underscore CSV of storing the variable df. So this data frame I'm calling here. So df dot drop now, inside that I'm passing argument in place is equal to true. Inside this, if we pass this argument in place is equal to true, it will remove all the empty cells or null values present in my original data itself. If I print my original data set, you can see here I'm doing df dot two underscore string, means it will print my data set into two string format, or you can directly print my df itself. I will print my data frame itself. If I run this program, you can see in the output. So as you can see in the my output, see duration, date here. Here, as you can see, I have not stored my removed empty cells, removed data set into a new data frame. I have not stored in a new variable. I am just directly converted my removed empty cells from my original data set itself. So in my original data set only, I have printed df. As you can see, in my original data frame itself, there is no null values present. As you can see, I have removed. If you are not passing this in place is equal to true, means it will not remove those empty cells from my original data set. It will just remove, and if you should store it in another variable, and you should use that new variable. If you are not passing in place is equal to true, means. So I will show you how it will get effect. If I just remove this in place is equal to true, means you will get to know. I will remove it and I will just run this program. You can see whether it has removed or not. So as you can see here, when I come down this here, my as I run the same program only, just remove that in place is equal to C. Here NAN empty cells is present here. If I just again I will place that one and I will run it again. You can see here, when I run it again, the empty cells has been removed my original data itself, data frame. So as you can see here, there is no NAN is present. So in this way, you can remove all the empty cells present in a particular original data itself using drop now, and you should pass in place is equal to true as a argument here. So next, I will show you how you can replace any empty values. That is removing the null values. If you want to replace any null values, like empty cells by empty values, means that now I will show you how we can do that. In order to do that, the inbuilt method available is fill null. So this is what the name of the function. This will like replace the empty values. It will fill with some values. So now I will show you. So import pandas as pd. So pd dot read underscore csv of new data csv, that now I am calling my original data set I am reading and stored in the variable df. So now I am calling df dot fill now, that is it will replace my empty cells with some data. So whatever the data set I have, all those null values I am replacing with the value 130 now. So whatever the value, with what values you want to replace the null values, that value you can present as the first argument. After that, in place is equal to true. Why I am giving again in place equal to true means all the empty cells values will be changed as a 130 in my original data frame itself. If I print my data frame, you will get to know what kind of output I will get. So as you can see, whatever the 130 you are seeing in my like in my data, it is nothing but the null values get empty cells got replaced by 130 here. If you want a better understanding, means we'll do now like that. Whatever the in place is equal to true have did here. Not now I will remove this one now, because as I am doing it in a Jupyter notebook, all the whatever I am doing it will be already like changed here. If you want to, so here I will first print my original data frame, and at the then only you will get to know whether it has just replaced my empty data cells with some value or not. You will get to know print of df. So I will run this one now here. Okay, print of df will do. So we'll run this now. Click on run. So whenever I run this program, see, when I run this program, you can see this is my original data set. So inside my original data set, as you can see, there are empty values present, nan, whatever nan you are saying, this is the empty values. Initially using drop now, we have just removed these empty values. Now in the original data set only you can remove. Here now I just keeping them in order to show you how we can replace this nan into some values. You can replace these empty values with empty cells with some values, that I will show you. What and all the nan I am having, that I am replacing with the number 130 now, that I will show you. In order to do that, I am using df dot fill now 130 comma in place is equal to true. The original data set itself I am replacing here. So we'll have printed my original data frame only. Now we'll see below whether it has got changed or not. So below whatever you are seeing here, duration it has started, it is the my data set which where I replaced my empty cells into value 130. Whether it replaced or not, we'll see now. In the calories I have 130. If I have 130, means it has replaced properly. So as you can see, whatever the 130.0 it is showing, it is previously nan. Now I have removed. Here also you can see 130. In that place, initially it was showing nan, how I showed you. Here it has removed, replaced as 130. So in this way it will work. Now I will replace some other value. You will get to know whatever the 130 I have showed you. Now I will replace it with 190. If I run this program, it should be replaced with that 190 value. That I will show you now. See, as you can see, I run the program. So here you may see here where nan is present. At the 18th row, nan is present. You can see here 18th row, 22th row has nan. In my replaced new in my now converted data frame, whether it has nan gas replaced with 190 or not, I will see 18th row and 20th row. We'll go to that 18th and 22nd row. So when I come to this 18th row, you can see here my nan has got replaced with 190. In similarly in the 22nd row, in 22nd row, you can see here my nan has got replaced with 190. So using this df dot fill now, you can replace the empty cells with some whatever the values you want. One more thing is, whenever you are like you are replacing or remove the empty cells, you can replace the value for that empty cells in a particular column also. You can do like whatever I have done, I have done it for the entire data frame. If you want to replace the values empty cells with some values in for the only for a particular column, if you want to replace means that also we can do that. I will show you now how we can do that. So import pandas as pd. So df pd dot read underscore cfp new data I am calling, showing in the variable df. So here initially I have replaced my data with 190. So here I am again replacing. I will show you how we can do it for a particular column only. We can replace the data of the particular column. If you want to do that, means you should call the data frame. So df of, so you should mention inside the df the name of that particular column. Here in the my data set have column name calories, that I am mentioning. In that calories name, if there is a empty cell is there, means at that place I should replace my empty cell value with 130. I am doing now. So df of calories inside the square two square like double quotes, you should mention the name of the column dot fillna. I am calling this fillna function now to replace the value. So I am replacing that empty cell with value 130. In place is equal to true I am giving. So in place is true means in my original data set itself I am like changing. After that I am printing my data frame. If I run this program, we will get whether my 190 which has present in this calories column calories column or the row 18th row, whether it has changed into 130 or not, we'll see. If it's changed, it have done it correctly. See, if I run this program, so we'll come to 18th row now. We come to 18th row. So when I am in 18th row now, now you go to calories column, that is the last column. See, as you can see the calories column, the earlier it has, first it was NaN, now in the last program I have replaced is 190. Now I change that 190 to 130. Particularly I have changed by 130 only to this calories column only. At this column only, what if there are any empty cell is there, that value I have changed to 130. As you can see it is 130, but at the 28th second row also in previous program I have changed it to 190. It should be 190 only, because I have modified only the this particular calories column and not modified this whatever the date column is there. In this date column I have not modified, it should be 190 only. I will show you. We come to the 22nd row. So as you can see here, in this 22nd row it is NaN, it is showing NaN. Why it is showing NaN means because I have again called my original data set here pd dot rate underscore. If I don't do this, means see, if I remove this one, means if I run it again, means it will show 190. It should show 190. See, we'll go to again 18th row, it will be same, 130 is there. I'll go to 22nd row, it is showing NaN here. As you can see here, we'll fill this one with 190. Now if you want to fill that particular with the 190, means we'll copy this one, whatever the thing we have done here. So just copy this one. We'll do it now. You'll get to know the difference. So here we'll paste this one and we'll run it again. So now we'll check now whether it has get updated or not. So now you can see here in the 18th row at the calories column, the NaN value got replaced with 130. But you come to 22nd row, whatever the NaN value was there in date column, it is 190 only. Whenever you do this directly without mentioning the column name, it will be affected with the whole data frame. If you directly want to modify the particular column, means data, means you want to replace with some value, means you should mention the name of that column. That is the difference between passing the name of the column and doing it with the entire data set. So as you can see here, in this way you can replace the empty cell with the some values also. Now I will show you how you can calculate mean, mode, median using in pandas for the data set whatever we have. So this mean, median or mode whatever we have, use these values we can calculate for a particular column also. That I will show you how we can do that. So import pandas as pd. Here I am going to show you how we can find mean of a particular column values, mean for the particular values present in a column. That I will show you now. So import pandas as pd. Now I will read the data set. So pd dot read underscore, see, whenever you read the data set, whatever the original data set we have in our memory or in our system, that will be read. So I am storing in a variable df. So now I am only calculating the mean of the particular column. The name of the column is calories. So df of calories dot mean I am calling here. So whatever the output I am getting, so dot mean of, so this is the inbuilt function available in this data frame pandas library in order to calculate the mean of a particular column values. So whatever the mean I am getting, storing in a variable x. So after that, see here, as you can see here, after calculating the mean, after the calculating mean, I am replacing wherever the null value is present in my particular calories column, I am replacing that empty cell with the mean value of that mean value of the calories column. So for that I am using df of calories dot fill. Now x I am using, x is nothing but here mean, in place is equal to mean, my original data set, wherever there is an empty cell, where there I am just replacing that original, that is empty cell with the mean of that column, calories column. If I run this program, we will get to know, we know that if the calories column, 18th row we have empty cell, whether at that place some mean value got replaced or not, we'll see now. If I run this program, see, when I run this program, you can see in the output, we'll come to 18th row now. So in the 18th row, see here in the 18th row, last column is the, this is nothing but empty, now is empty cell. Now it has replaced with 304.68. So the 304.68 is the mean of that calories column. So I have replaced that empty cell with the mean of that particular column. So in this way, using this mean, you can find out the mean. If you are replacing the empty cell with the mean of the value means, it will be almost you will not get you will get a well with well accuracy. In this way also you can make use of this mean, or you can also find the mean of the whole data set itself also. Generally will provide mean of a particular column. This, so calculating mean mainly help us, like in this way you can replace that instead of replacing that empty cell with some other value, if you replace it with a mean value, it will be like more accurate. Now I will show you how to mean. You know that mean is nothing but average, that is sum of all the value divided by number of values. So now I will show you how we can do it same by calculating the median. So import pandas as pd. So I am again importing the data set. So pd dot read underscore csv, new data csv format data set, I am calling and storing in the data, converted data frame, storing in the variable df. So now df of calories, again I am using the calories column. Now dot median of, now I am calculating median of that column present in this calories column present in the data frame, whatever the output median I am getting of that column, storing in a variable x. So now I will replace, if there is an empty cell present in my calories column, means that I am replacing with the whatever the median I have calculated. So df of calories dot fill now, so x is nothing but median here, in place is equal to true. If I run this program, you can see whether at the empty cell present in this particular data set has been replaced with the median of that particular column or not. I will run this program and you can see in the output now. See, there is an empty cell present in the 18th row in the calories column. We'll go to that row now. When I come to 18th row, initially now it should be replaced with median value of that particular column. So in the 18th row, as you can see here, calories column, it is not empty, it is replaced with 291.2. so whatever the 291.2 is here seeing, this is the median value of this particular calories column. So in this way you can also calculate the median, and you can replace with the empty cell, or you can directly calculate if you want particular column also, you can calculate the median value. Next I will find how we can median. As I told, median is nothing but the value in the middle after you have sorted all the values in the ascending order. That is what the meaning of median is, nothing but whatever all the different values present in the particular calories column, it will be sorted in like ascending order. After sorted, whatever the middle value will get, that is nothing but the median generally. So next I will show you how we can calculate the mode, and we'll replace with any empty values with it. We'll do it for the same calories column. So import pandas as pd, pd dot read underscore ca, data set will read, and you stored in the variable df, is the data frame. So df of calories in the data frame, at the calories column, I calculate the mode. So mode of, here whenever you're calculating mode, you should pass this index 0, whatever the mode I'm getting, showing in the variable x. So now we'll replace empty cell present in calories column with the mode. So df of calories dot fill now, x comma in place is equal to true, we'll do that. We'll print our data frame. If I run this program, you can see the output now. See, in the output now, my See, we'll come to now 18th row, because we know that the 18th row calories column have that empty cell, whether it has changed to any mode or not. So in the 18th row calories column, as you can see, previously when I calculated mean, it is replaced with 302 something. When I calculated mode, like median, it is 291 point. Now I have calculated mode. The mode of the value is in 300. As you can see, it is replaced with this empty cell. So in this way, you can calculate mean, mode, and median in using Pandas library. Now we'll see data cleaning in Pandas library. So here I'm going to show you what and all the different methods available inside this Pandas library, where in order to do different operations. So here there is an inbuilt method available inside Pandas, that is to_date_timeoff method. What this method will do, I will show you. So here first we'll import Pandas library. So import Pandas as PD. After that, whatever the data set which I have taken earlier, the same data set I am loading here. So pd.read_csv. So it is in order to read the CSV data set. So the name of the data set which I have taken is newdata.csv, which is already present inside my system. So here there is a separate column present inside this data set, that is a date. So in the from that data set, I am going to get the date time now. So df of data from that data frame, a column date I am accessing equal to pd.to_data_time, that is this user inbuilt function inside the Pandas. Now I am calling pd.to_date_time of df of date. So here what I am trying to do is, whatever the date column present inside this data set, that I am trying to change it to the particular whatever the present date time is there, that time I am going to assign to that particular date column. Now if I print my original data frame, you can see in the change in the output now. So when I run this program, see, you can see in the output here, now it is showing date. See here. So in this way, you can make use of this date, that is a to_date_timeoff function. Like it is mainly help us to convert into a particular date type format. So initially this was my original data frame. You can see here it was in some other format. When I change using this to_date_time, so it has got converted into proper date time format. Now I will show remove. Like if you want to replace a particular value present in the particular row of this data frame, that also we can do now. So that I will show you how that can be done. So here, whatever the data frame which I have created, from that, in order to access the particular location, I am using the inbuilt function here. So df.loc location of, here I am passing first parameter, the particular row, so 7th row. The column name I am passing as duration here. In the column name duration, the 7th row I am accessing. In the 7th row, at that position, whatever the value present, that now I am changing that value to equal to 45. So if I print my data frame, now the value get changed now. So you can see in my original data frame. So before changing only, I will print my original data frame also. You can get to know the difference now. So print of df will do. So after that, we'll print again the changed data frame. I will run this program now. You can see in the output how we can replace a particular value present in a column. So here, in my original data frame, in the duration column, at the 7th row, you can see now it is 450 is there. Initially, you can see here, when I change the particular row value it to 45, so you can change my change data frame, it is below. Now you can see here in the 7th row, in the duration column, now it is changed to 45. So initially it was 450, now I have changed it to 45. So in this way, using this dot location of that, you can access and replace the whatever the value present in a particular cell in a data frame. Next, we can also loop through all the values present in the data frame. That I will show you how we can do that. Whatever the data frame initially I have created, the same thing I am using here. So for x in df dot index, what it will do is it is going to fetch the index number from the data frame that I am going to assign it to x. Index number it is nothing but the row number it will give, whatever the particular row number is there, that it's all from zero. So whatever the row I am getting, that I am assigning from that row, I am using as a like in a index value in order to access the particular row. So if of I am checking if of df dot location of x is nothing but rows number in the duration column. Now I am checking if the value present in that particular cell is greater than 120 means. Now I am, if it is greater than 120 means, now I am assigning that those column cell values to 120 now. So df dot location of x comma in the square bracket duration column I am equal to 120 means. If the particular cell present in the duration cell, if its value is greater than 120 means, now I am reassigning it to 120. So if I print my data frame, you can see in the output. So I will print my original data frame also. First, initially, you can see the difference between original and modified data frame. So we'll print our modified data frame also. If I run this program, you can see in the output now. So whatever you are seeing, this is was my original data frame. In this in the duration column, you can see there are no column which is greater than 120 here. So when I check the condition, none of them is like satisfying the condition. So whatever the values they have initially, it will be remained same. So you can see in the output here, if I change this my condition less greater than 120 to less than 120, you can see in the like change in the output now. So now I will change my condition here. If I run this program, you can see in the output. See, initially whatever the duration rows values present in the duration column, it was 60-40 original data frame. When I check the condition, if it whatever the cell value present is less than 120 means, I am going to assign the mass equal to 120. So when I run this program, you can see all the column like all the rows present in that particular duration column, now all the values got changed to 120, because whatever the all the different rows present in this particular column, all the values are less than 120 only. So only all the values values got changed into 120. You can set a different condition also. So in this way you can change more than one cell value in this data frame. So now we will see some other condition now. So here for same data frame I am trying to access. So for x in df dot index, so it is going to fetch the index number which is nothing but the particular row number. So whatever the row number I am getting, that I am going to use inside this location inbuilt function in order to access the particular cell. So now I am checking if of df dot location of x in the duration column, whatever the values it has, it is greater than 120. I am checking. If it is greater than 120 means df dot drop. So now I am trying to drop that particular row. If the particular row present in that duration column, if the value is greater than 120 means, I am going to remove that particular row from my original data frame. So df dot drop of x comma in place is equal to true. This one you should mention. If I print my data frame, when I run this program, you can see in the output, I am not going to remove any. See, as you can see in the output, none of the rows got removed here because all of them are less than 120, so it is not removing. If I check whatever the data frame which have initially changed here 120, so this condition here itself I will change here. I will make it again greater than 120. I will run it again. So now in this particular program here, whatever the 120 is there, now I will change it to greater than some other value, greater than 45 will set now. So now I will print both my modified and original data frame. You can see in the output. So print of df will do. So we'll print again the modified data frame also. So if I run this program, you can see in the output, you can see in the output the values which is greater than 45 are those rows I am removing. First I have printed my original data frame. Here it is showing duration is 120 120, all of them which has changed in my previous program. So here as you can see, when I print my new data frame after modifying like that, like whatever the values present in the duration column, if value is greater than 45 means that particular row I am removing here. So my output is empty data frame. You can see why I am getting empty data frame is because all the values present in this duration column is 120. So only I am getting my output as an empty data frame because it has removed all the data frame. So in this way also you can drop a particular row present or more than one row also you can drop from a data frame. So next I will show you how we can get duplicate values in present in the data frame in a particular column. So in order to find the duplicate, there is an inbuilt method that is duplicated up. Whenever you call this inbuilt method, it will mainly returns a boolean values for each row, whether any duplicate value present or not, it will give as a true or false as a output. We'll call that method now. So whatever the data frame initially which I have created, now I am calling for that data frame only. So df dot duplicated up. And I call this program. If I run this program, you can see in the output now. So it is showing. So only there is no like none of them has any duplicate values in my data frame. Here we'll call our original data frame. Once again we'll create a data frame and we'll call that function again. Here itself will copy that program. So we'll run it. You can see in the output it is showing false, false, false. At a particular row where there is a duplicate value present, it is showing. So at the 0th row there is no duplicate value, it is showing false. At the 12th row, as you can see, it is showing output as true. So in the 12th row in my particular data frame, there is a duplicate value present, only it is showing true. So in this way you can get to know whether any duplicate value present in your data frame or not. So how we can remove that particular duplicated values from the data frame is there is one more inbuilt method available in pandas, that is drop underscore duplicates of. If you use this method, it will drop the particular duplicated row values. So the same data frame which I have created, now I am calling it. So df dot drop underscore duplicates of. So this inbuilt function I am calling here, in place is equal to true. So this argument you should pass in order to drop the duplicated values. And I print my data frame after removing the duplicated values. You can see in the output now the duplicated value which was present in the which was true showing is in the 12th row. You can see in the 12th row now there is no duplicate value present here. See, as you can see here, there is a 12th row has been removed from my data frame. As you can see, after 10 it is showing 11, after 11 only 13 it is showing. 12 the row 12 has been removed because the row whatever the values present in the 12th row, it was the duplicated value, so it has removed my duplicated row. So in this way you can find out the duplicate value where particular which row has a duplicate values, and you can also drop that duplicated values using drop underscore duplicates of method. And also you can find the correlation like between the different columns are correlation between different, like each between each column present in the data set also you can find the correlation. There is an inbuilt method available in pandas, that is cor of. So if you call this method, it will going to find the correlation between different columns present in the pandas library, like particular data set which have used. So here I'm calling that correlation method. So the same data frame which I have created earlier, so now I'm calling df dot cor of. When I call this function, so when I run this function, you can see in the output. See, you can see in the output now, it is showing correlation between different columns present in this particular data frame. So it is going to find the correlation between duration and duration. It is showing correlation is 1. Between duration and pulse, the correlation is 0.0026. Similarly, duration between max pulse, duration between calories, similarly pulse between duration. So in this way, the correlation between different columns, it is going to fetch as the output when I call this correlation inbuilt method available in pandas library. If there is any non-numeric columns present in the data frame, means the correlation method, it is going to ignore those non-numeric columns and it is going to fetch the correlation by considering only numeric columns. It will consider, because here whatever the data set which I have, it has only all the values or only numeric values. So it has fetched the output of all of them. Here one more thing you can notice here, it has not considered the date column, because it is not a numeric value, because date have given within the single quote is nothing but it is considered it as a string. So only my output you can see here, it has not considered while finding the correlation, date column is not present here. Only the four other columns, duration, pulse, max pulse, calories, it has only numeric values. So it has found the correlation between all the different columns. So in this way you can make use of this cor method in order to find the correlation between all the columns present in the data frame. So whatever the output will get, it will between minus 1 and 1 only. So you can see here my maximum value is 1 here, and it has got values in minus also. So it will give the correlation values between minus 1 to plus 1 only. That is the range of that output. So next I am going to show you, whenever we got some printer, like using the pandas library, when we read some data set, whether either we are going to plot some graph based on the different columns present in the data set, in order to, it will help us to analyze the data, very helpful. So using pandas library, making use of one more library, like help of the matplotlib library, we are going to draw some graph based on the different columns present in my data set. Now I will show you how we can do that. First we import pandas as pd. After that, in order to plot the different graphs, I am going to call a matplotlib library. So import matplotlib dot, from that matplotlib I am calling pyplot as plt. So now I am taking alias name as plt. So using with the help of this matplotlib library, I am going to draw a graph according to according to whatever the different columns present in my data set which I have calling here, like loading here using pandas. So pd dot read underscore csv of the name of the data set which I have is new data dot csv, whatever the data set which I have called using this read underscore csv. Now I am turning into change into a data frame, storing in a variable df. So now I am going to plot my data frame. So here df dot plot of, so if you call this df dot plot of, it is going to plot graph. It will be plotted according to different values present inside this data set, different columns. So after calling this df dot plot of, in order to see my output, plotted output, I am calling plt dot show of. So this plt dot show of method is going to draw that particular graph I show in my output window. So if I run this program, you can see in the output now. So it is showing only the figure size, whatever the output I am getting, the size of that window will be 640 into 480, that will also show, and it will also going to show the plot also. See, you can see in the plotting library. So what, only the four columns which are present in my data frame, that is mainly duration, pulse, max pulse, calories. So the particular color will be assigned to each column name. So duration has different colors, similarly pulse has orange, max pulse green, like that. Each color will represent the particular column present in the data set, and it has plotted a graph here. So this will help us to analyze the data, what and all the different data present in my particular data set. So with the help of matplotlib, you can plot
the like plot the different datas present in a particular data set. So there are different kinds of plot you can do using this with the help of this matplotlib library. So this is when I call it directly with the data frame like df.plot, it is going to draw according to the different all the considering all the columns present in the data set. If you want to plot like only for a particular column present in the data set, that also you can do. That I will show you how we can do that. So here in this particular example, first I am importing the pandas. So import pandas as pd, and I am importing both matplotlib library also here. So after importing, we'll load our data set here. So pd.read_csv, this is in order to read the data set which is in CSV format. So after loading the data set, my data frame is stored in the variable df. So now I am plotting the plotting only the two, by considering only two columns present in my data frame. So df.plotof, I am calling the plotting library present in matplotlib. So df.plotof, here kind is nothing but what kind of plot we want in the output, that we should mention in the kind. So kind equal to scatter, I am giving here inside the single quote. Scatter means whatever the output plotting I am doing, that should be in a scatter plot. So after that, x equal to duration I am giving. So in the x axis I should consider the values present in the duration column. After that comma, y equal to calories. So in the y axis I should consider the values present in the calories. So here whatever the plot I am getting, it is a plot of duration versus calories I am doing, that is x versus y column. So in that particular x and y, what values should I take, that I am mentioning here. So if I, in order to finally see my plotted like graph, I am writing here plt.showoff. When I run this program, you can see in the output whatever the graph I got, it is the plot between the column duration and calories which is present in x and y axis. So it has plotted a scattered library based on different values stored inside this particular data frame. So in this way also you can draw a graph between the desired, like what and all the different columns you have. Particular columns also you can consider in order to draw the graph. Now you can see the same whatever the thing I have got here. So here I draw graph between duration and calories. Next I will consider two more different columns here. So here import pandas as pld, so import matplotlib.plt as plt. So here same reading the data set. So now I am plotting the df.plot of kind, the same scatter I am calling, x equal to duration. In the y axis now I am changing it to max pulse. So I am finally, so in order to see the output, plt.showoff. When I run this program, you can see in the output now a scattered plot you are getting here, that is between duration and max pulse. So it has plotted based on the different values present in these two columns, duration and max pulse. So there are different kinds of plotting also available in this matplot library. And there is a one more kind of plotting is available, that is based on the histogram it will print. So if you want to plot that like that plot, if you want to get me, while calling that plot function inside that in the kind where I gave here scatter as a kind of plot which I wanted, if you want histogram plot, means inside that kind equal to you should give hist. So that is the only difference. If you give like that, means you are going to get a plot with hist. So that I will show you now how that histogram plot will plot. So here I am calling. So here for a particular column only I am plotting now. So df of duration, so in the data frame there is a column named duration, for that I am plotting now graph. So df of duration dot plot of, inside that I am just giving here kind is equal to hist, means it is going to plot the data frame histogram data frame. So we'll see our, in order to see the output, do plt dot show. So plt dot show of, if I run this program, you can see in the output now. You can see in the output whatever the output I have got is a histogram plot for the values present inside the duration column. So this is how a histogram plot will look like, as you can see here. So these are the different methods or inbuilt functions available in pandas library. So mainly this pandas library will be used in machine learning and Python in order to load the data set and in order to do different operations related to data sets only. So as I shown you different examples, like how we can use different inbuilt methods available in this pandas library. So in this way you can make. So thank you for watching the video. Thank you.